What I don't quite see yet is opportunities, educational opportunities, the drugs, the gangs. You know, it seems like every block has a gang. This culture of violence, if anything, it's idolized. You know, and why should we care?
Today, in what will go down in history as the greatest demonstration for freedom in the history of our nation.
So it seems I'm lost in between exotic cars and fiends, palms hella itchy. Baby mama bitchy, dishwasher broke cause them pots too sticky. Snap back to the back cause I got that crack.
When we think about a rundown urbanized enclave, you know, we're looking at abandoned warehouses, possibly, you know, abandoned buildings, places in disrepair, you know, crumbling infrastructure, graffiti.
And when they're not in school, obviously they're out in the corner, they're hanging out, they're getting themselves in trouble. And once you get in trouble once, then it becomes twice, three times, and you join this, you know, cycle of violence even, and all these other social issues that make the situation worse.
And that's every nigga's situation in a town where them gang signs go up and them bitches going down. Life is but a dream. Life is but a dream. Life is but a dream. Life is everything but a dream.
If you look at the definition of gang, you know, how is it defined by the FBI or the CIA, you'd be surprised at.
In terms of gangs, you know, kids participate, it ends up becoming, you know, an identity statement in many cases. Crucified, police are the crucifers. Shoot us up and dig a ditch. This ain't nothing
new to us. Murders happen every day. Kids on their merry way. Gang doesn't have to be precisely a group of people dealing with drugs or guns. You know, there's a broader definition to it. If anything, what a gang will offer is a sense of belonging. You want to be a part of something. You want to feel like you have a brotherhood. I'm just trying to fulfill my wish list.
Don't want to be another statistic. I think that gangs are often scapegoated as, you know, the sort of real reason that, you know, folks aren't doing other things with their lives. But actually, gangs and drugs are already symptoms of the lack of structural opportunities that are there.
Disintegration of a family, when you have a disintegration of a society, and this is the one option that allows you to be a part of something, I think is an easy choice.
So when kids are coming from disadvantaged families, the likelihood that they're going to have disadvantaged lives themselves is high. My quietly hope for change when violence is the rhythm inspired me to obtain the silence in this room with 20 zannies and strolls and grown-up candy. I lost it. I feel it's nothing to lose. The street short to release the worst side of my best. Don't mind, cause now you up on your neck. The good kid, Mad City.
No one else is presenting another alternative. If you were to tell a child If you do this, look what happened. Look what happened to your siblings or your parents. If you consider this other option, this is what you could do. I'm a product of public education. I can tell you that it was easier for me to not go to class and be absent, and no one would have ever noticed. When you have a class of 30, 40 kids for a classroom that probably is meant to be for 15 kids, you easily become a number.
If you are in neighborhoods where there's not, you know, a high school graduation rate, or there's not a college graduation rate, you know, you're going to pursue the kinds of options that make sense in your local environment. I ain't got nothing in common with this pain in my heart. It's as black as my skin. They tipping the scale for these crackers to win. No reading, no writing, made a savage of men. They praying for jail, but I mastered the pen. The
key problems, at least for me, growing up in the South Bronx at the time, is that education was based on safety. You know, most of the investment in education was going into metal detectors, police officers, and not so much in books, not so much in after school programs, not so much into building new parks. Overnight I seen a nigga go get a Carrera. 2 weeks later I had to be that boy Paul Bearer. The high school that I attended, Southmore High School, right next to it, two blocks away from it, they built a brand new juvenile center. You know, so the message was clear. If you don't finish high school, that's where you will end up. You know, so, but there was money to invest in a new jail, but not in a new school. When you feed no hate, you empty my nigga, it shows. Follow the codes, ain't no love for these souls. If you slip and you fall, I got you, my nigga, hold on. If you right or you wrong, if you ride, come on. By the end of this song, I got you, my nigga, hold on. I got you, my nigga, hold on. I got you, my nigga, hold on. If you right or you wrong, if you ride, come on. By the end of this song, I got you, my nigga, hold on. A lot of things need to change. And again, it goes back to the idea of opportunities. I think it's important for us as a society to reconsider ourselves, you know, to take responsibility for our actions, to find ways to engage our kids. I drew a two of hearts from a deck of cards, a stock trick from my empty repertoire. Troy, Mark, and Lil, what's his name? Memory is rerunning it all. It's the flight of my fall, and it's right on the wall.
You know, while we bill ourselves as, you know, being really big on class mobility and practice, you know, we're not. So people don't tend to land, except for, you know, very unique situations, more than a couple shades to the left or a couple shades to the right of where they start out. Can
you remember how it was? There is a way out. I still believe in the American dream. I'm living the American dream. I think that this country is built on people like myself, you know, who always have had to do an extra human effort to better themselves. But there's a lot that we can do at an institutional level, at a family level, and at an individual level to change things.